Good morning, Maria.
I'm Randy Hart. Really, I serve several roles, and serving as the dean for the College of Agricultural Sciences and Natural Resources. And I'm in the process of, we have a search committee going on right now, so I haven't come in the process of hiring any faculty member. That'll actually take care of this in the future. So I realize the importance of this program, so I started this last year, if I can remember. And so I want to carry through this year. As you saw in my script, that we were allocated some funds last year. We have used most of those funds, not all of those funds. So in my budget request, I explained what we used, how much we had left, how much was going to carry over, and how much we need to carry, how much we need for the future, and then what the differences were, and so forth. This is labeled as livestock slash meat judging. And right now, we have started a livestock team. Next year, we anticipate also adding a meat judging team. So that explains why we still continue to need, because we're going to have two groups of students to enhance participation by more students. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and get started, but I thought I'd at least explain that initially. Because that's one of the questions you had for me, I'm sure, at the end. And the questions we have to answer to start with is, how do we help students? In other words, what programs, what degree plans, what activities, what engagement can we use to help our students? That's what we're here for. If we didn't have our students, we wouldn't be here. Okay. What are learning opportunities to achieve this task? What is the importance of our efforts? We have to always look at diversity. And in my interview, Paul, if you remember 2 years ago when I came in and interviewed, I had the question. Every interview question I had was about diversity. And my answer was, it wasn't about race. It wasn't about those types of typical things. Simply, it was about philosophy and various programs, various thoughts, is also diversity. So when I look for my role, when I look at offering programs or engagement for students, then everyone and every group is important. And so I have to look at the big picture. And even though I'm representing this group today, just one of the many groups that I'm sure you're looking at, we truly appreciate how you helped us to get started last year. We are in our infancy in this program. And as you also may realize through an email, over the last couple weeks. 5 years ago, we were a department within the College of Science, Engineering, and Agriculture. Then we were a School of Agriculture for about 3 years or so. Now, this January, we are now a College of Agriculture. We have grown, and I've got to this point on here in a few minutes, but we've grown about 57% the last 3.5-4 years. So for us to continue to grow, for us to continue to build our college, we have to have programs that we can offer students so they will come here instead of going somewhere else. We have to offer programs for our students that are here to retain them and keep them here, because we're in a competitive world. So diversity is very important. No matter what program it is, I'm going to support it. Okay. I don't care if it's not my college, I'm still going to support it, because we're here for students. How do we do this in agriculture, and how does agriculture fit across the curriculum? We teach math, we teach English, we have writing, we do business principles, we are agricultural sciences, so we do science. We do everything across the curriculum in agriculture. And so our students gain everything from those other areas. So, as I said, agriculture supplies about 14% to 17%, and I like to say a little bit more, but statistics that we lately see is 14% to 17% of all jobs in the United States are related to agriculture. That's directly. Indirectly, it's about 20% to 23%. Did anybody eat breakfast this morning?
Yeah.
You got some goodies back there?
Yeah, we do.
You gonna have lunch today?
Yeah.
Hopefully. Appreciate agriculture. If you didn't have agriculture, you wouldn't have any of that food. And so really, that's what we're about. Now, Tim Letzring, he's the dean of the College of Education. He says, every time you read, appreciate education. So we both have something really to stand on. And we both have something that's really important in our daily lives. Our job is to simply feed the world. You know, we had former UN Ambassador Andrew Young here on campus to dedicate the Talbot Building last year. Since he was here, and based on conversations we've had, we've now had Ambassador Young back here on campus a couple more times. I've been to visit him in Atlanta, Georgia. I just got back from Washington, D.C. with a meeting with him at the USDA building in Washington, D.C. We're discussing various ways that we here at A&M Commerce can help and make a difference in providing food and especially protein to the world. That's what his foundation is all about. That's what we're about. So we're joining forces to be able to do that. There is an increase in demands for food, specifically protein. That can be reached through selection, evaluation, the production of livestock, and through plant products. So we're going to be slow. Oh, where are you going? There. Thank you, Brian. This is where we train our future food suppliers. And let me emphasize that this program is open for anybody on campus. I have had business administration majors. I've had accounting majors. I've had medical pre-med majors. Yes, we have a lot of ag majors. But anything that pertains to food, anything that pertains to the food industry. In fact, when we look at teaching our students, I've got another slide up here in a minute. I'll get to it. Three of our signature courses last fall had something to do with food. Another signature course in the spring had something to do with food. So it's very, very important. This is an avenue where we take our students and we teach them responsibility, time management, networking, leadership, industry relevance, teamwork, relationship building, salesmanship, and competitiveness, all in one big swoop. 1 minute. So we have grown over 40% in the last 3 years. Students learn to network within the industry with alumni, government agencies, politicians, faculty and staff, and most importantly, each other. When we have a look at comparisons of other schools in the A&M system, if we don't do this, we don't compete. A team just walked in back there, and he's a competitor. We all know that, okay? We have competition in football. He has several kids on the football team. He only plays 11 at a time. We recruit several students, young people, for our competitive teams. We only may judge 5 at a time, just like a basketball team only plays 5 at a time. But we will still, over a 4-year period, because they only have, once they're here, they only have 1 year of eligibility for that team. It's not like football where they play 4 years. They can just play 1 year after we get here in training. So we are constantly revolving and training and bringing in students and moving them from one group to another, where we will have 80 to 100 students in a 4-year period through these programs. Time's up.
Time's up.
Thank you.
We have questions
I did put your questions up there. Okay.
We have questions for Dr. Harp.
Yes.
So can you tell me a little bit about what your department is doing to generate revenue to support such initiatives?
Absolutely. We are engaging and starting 3 alumni groups in regions with the foundation and with alumni, with Sam Walker, with Katuri Beatty. We are working diligently to start those alumni groups, to start working on endowments. We already have some endowments. We already have an excellence fund that we can draw from some. We don't have enough of those funds at this time to get these programs going. I was sitting where you were at Tarleton for several years, and that's where their ability to have these teams came from, is from student service fee funds. We also had alumni funds that we would raise about $10,000-$20,000 a year to subsidize that with. We also grew a scholarship over years, but it takes years. It can't just be done in 1 year. So yes, we have initiated, since I've been here, some alumni groups to start raising funds to help this grow, because I believe I put in the summary, 3 or 4 page summary that I gave, that we are soliciting funds. We are raising outside funds. This is not all that we need. So we are going to be raising funds in addition to what we're requesting here. Yes, ma'am.
Well, my question was just related to why the Ag Department itself can't pay for its own GA.
We don't have the budget.
Even with all the growth?
Even with all the growth. We have allocated 4 GAs for the entire college. That's it. And so when we add GA, and those are GARs, those are graduate students, assistants in research. This student hopefully will be doing some research, but at the same time, their primary mission is to be helping teaching and be coaching this team under the supervision of this new faculty member that we're hiring. And with 2 teams, with 1 faculty member, they can't catch both. So I'm at least going to have 1 graduate student coaching one of the teams and the faculty member coaching the other team. So we need the graduate student from that standpoint.
Dr. Harper, have you thought about, I'm trying to think outside the box where you can find some additional funding, utilizing livestock meat judging because you compete against other teams from other schools? Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like a club sport, although it's not necessarily what I would define as a sport itself. It might be possible for you to get some funding from Campus Recreation through their club sport program. Might be worth a conversation at least. And it might not be a lot of money, but even if it's a couple thousand, that's gonna help. That's gonna help you out.
Would Rick be the person to do something?
I would start with Rick, yeah.
I haven't gone in that direction. I will, now that you say that. I'd be happy to.
I don't see it
as a sport. Our rodeo group is more of a sport than this group would be. This group actually, and let me reemphasize this, 7 minutes is difficult.
We get 8 minutes.
Especially like me. This is an opportunity for these students that are on these teams. Mm-hmm. Just competing is not the only element. Mm-hmm. The element is also taking these students to industry. You know, we can sit in the classroom all day long. We can go out to the farm for a lab. But the real education that these students, many of these students, 5 may be judging in a competition, but there may be 12 on the trip. There may be 20 going after the team this year. All of them are going to gain, and they're going to gain that networking. They're going to gain the field experience, so to speak, with industry, with alumni, with careers, jobs. You know, this meat judging team, they will be going to all the major meat packing companies in the country.
Awesome.
And when they win, those people will be asked to say, where are they going to work? They're not going to be asking the last place team.
Yeah.
Team can relate to that too. If you're not winning, they're not asking you, where's your best player? They want your best. They want your best player. They want a winner. And so part of this is teaching competition, and because it's a competitive world.
Sure. So. I'm just trying to think outside the box.
No, I appreciate it. In the past we have had. Daryl Hart may not like this, but in the past we've had plant sales.
Sure.
We've done ribeye steak sales.
Yeah.
Tina would like that.
Yeah.
And
let me know if you do that again.
when we get a meat lab, we will. Okay. There are numerous avenues to raise outside funds. But at the same time, I can also tell you too, if we're spending all our time raising outside funds, we don't have time to practice.
Sure.
And therefore we can't be competitive. Because I've been on both sides of that coin. I've been in a place where we spent all our time raising funds, and then we came in next to last or in the bottom. It was in the upper 10% of the lower 1/3 or something like that. But at the same time, when we had the support and we could go recruit some of the best students, then we won national championships. You know, I've been a part of 12 national championships as a coach and as a faculty member in my 35-year career. And this is essential. Whether you give us all of what we request or not, any or all parts is essential for us to continue to grow, help our students, fund these experiences that these young people give.
Awesome. Other questions for Dr. Hart? Appreciate your time, sir.
Thank you. Appreciate it.